home thoughts from abroad.
Thank you to all of the crews who flew and participated today. And there was quite a contingent from abroad, which is a good thing. After all, it's Europe. And another good thing, too, if you take a perspective, the sight of this last pass with the leader flying, what was he flying back? It was flying TF-51. First time, and on its right wing for the night. And that's history. That's what happened 60 years ago. Probably we're here today mixing German crosses with RAF Rambles and American stores and French Rambles, Russian Red Star, whatever. And that was the same as this place. But the humans are still there.
Congested southbound, so we recommend you not trying to rush off, have a wander around for a little while and ease the congestion as the vehicles are going out. M11 southbound is congested.
Not completely stopped. Police advise us that it is very heavily congested and moving extremely slow.
Anyway, this is one of the best moments. It's when the aircraft come back off of the slots and the propellers gently stop. And when the silence comes again on the platform. That's for the airplane. It's still right in this. This is the only airplane in the world where this can happen. Year after year after year. And, That's the spot in this planet which eventually this part of history, and it's fun to think that maybe for a century from now every year there will still be one legend airship. One interesting thing about that: not many things in life get better. Flying legends become sort of does get better than the years to come. Just that time. Landing. Bumping, I must say. Leo Matisse flying the one and only Focke-Wulf 190 flying currently in this planet's atmosphere. And Spitfires. Ladies and gentlemen, he's now walking from right to left in front of the control tower, but would you please give him now his board because...
That's a funny sign, Stephen. What was that for?
Is that what you're talking about?